Am I awake? What's going on? Why can't I move? What are all these voices I'm hearing? What on earth was that? I can't move. I'm still there. Why does my chest feel so heavy?
Nelson, we're ready for you.
Yeah, I'm here.
Come in.
Hey, Doc. I just woke up a couple of hours ago, and I had the weirdest experience. While I was sleeping, I felt chained to my bed. I was hearing weird sounds, and there were creepy figures looking over me. But it didn't feel like a dream. I felt awake throughout the whole thing. Should I be worried about this?
Hey! It seems like you're describing sleep paralysis.
What's that?
Well, basically, when we sleep, we go through different stages, almost like a cycle. The first stage is when you're just starting to doze off. Your body relaxes and your breathing slows down. Then, we go into a deeper sleep, which is when the body starts to repair itself and gets a good rest. Now, there's one stage called REM sleep, or rapid eye movement sleep. This is when we do most of our dreaming. In REM sleep, the brain is very active, but the interesting thing is your body becomes temporarily paralyzed. This is actually a good thing because it keeps us from acting out our dreams. Imagine if you started running in your dream and your body actually tried to run while you were dreaming. That wouldn't be safe, right? So during sleep paralysis, your brain wakes up before your body does. You become unaware of your surroundings, but you're still in that REM stage where your body is locked and unable to move. That's why you feel awake but can't move or speak.
Alright, but how come I saw scary figures? And why did my chest feel so heavy, as if someone was sitting on it?
Yeah, that's a common symptom. In fact, roughly half of the people that experience sleep paralysis noted both of those symptoms. This happens because your brain is still in a dreamlike state. The feelings and hallucinations of someone sitting on your chest is a phenomenon called incubus hallucination, while the feelings of an evil malevolent figure approaching you are referred to as intruder hallucinations. The good news is that it's harmless and typically only lasts a few seconds to minutes, even though it feels longer.
Is there a way I can avoid this from happening again?
There is still a lot of research being done on sleep paralysis. However, we do know that age does not play a factor. Also, research has found that this is more prevalent in the male sex rather than the female. Other mental conditions or sleep disorders, such as narcolepsy, stress, or bipolar disorder, can also cause these episodes to occur, with differing symptoms and experiences. But since you have not been diagnosed with any mental disorders, research says that the main thing for you is probably a lack of sleep or constant changes to your sleep cycle, which is driving these episodes to occur. So it is very important that you get adequate quality and quantity of sleep on a regular basis.
Well, that relieves a lot of my worries. Thank you so much for answering my questions. It's nice knowing I'm not the only one that went through this, and I'll be sure to prioritize my sleep going forward.
You are very welcome. Let me know if you have any other questions.
If you experience sleep paralysis, you are not alone. But to help prevent it, focus on maintaining a consistent sleep schedule and managing your stress levels. Remember, prioritizing your sleep health is key. And if you like this video, please subscribe to Demystifying Medicine for more videos.